families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board and every point is worth 50 Rand. In round 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 Rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for Steve Harvey!
Thank you very much. Thank y'all. Well, welcome to Family Feud South Africa, everybody. I'm your mayor, Steve Harvey. I know what you're thinking. I bet y'all thought you'd never see me again. But I'm back. Matter of fact, right back. Look, I had such a great time meeting everybody. I just had to come back and find out more about South Africa. Y'all, these crazy people over here. I want you to understand something that I've learned about South Africans, as I have with all Africans. You all are just like the black people in the United States. The food is a little different. The words are very different. The women are beautiful. And the men are men. So, hey, let me explain to you how this works, everybody. Our researchers have been out on the streets of Mzansi. And they have been asking for answers to some very simple questions. Now, the answers are locked into our game board up here. All these families got to do is match those answers, and the families can walk away with some serious money and a chance to win a jackpot, 75,000 Rand. Yeah. The families from Linmeyer, it's the Mode family.
Let's go.
Playing against from Turfantine, who? It's the, it's the other family. Okay, pronounce it for me.
KHUZWAYO.
Ladies and gentlemen, the KHUZWAYO family. KHUZWAYO, yes. The Mode family. The KHUZWAYO family. The Mode. The KHUZWAYO. Got it. Well, we might as well get it going. Y'all ready for the show to get started?
Yeah.
Let's go. Give me cred, give me honor. All right, guys, here we go. We got the top 7 answers on the board. Name something people enjoy most about a metric dance.
The music.
The music. Ona?
The dressing up.
The dressing up.
We're going. Yes. I'm super excited. I am. So much. I can't believe it.
This is for you. Yes. Take it in. What do you do?
I'm a student advisor at the university.
Oh, really? What's the name of the school?
University of Pretoria.
Okay, that's good. So, I want to introduce everybody.
All right, Steve, over here to my right. We have our superstar of the family, Basi, that is short for Basitana. Yes, he's a superstar. Then followed by Andile, he's the photographer of the family.
It's good.
Up next, we have the smarty pants of our family. We have Lesego. Then lastly, the famous soccer player.
Oh, he's famous.
Yes, I am.
To us, to our family.
Yes.
He's the famous one. Mr. Kuzan.
Hold on. This is a famous soccer player?
Yes.
So let me just stop for 1 second. What team do you play for?
You. The KHUZWAYOs. That's the team I play for.
Oh, your family?
Yes.
Oh, so you are going to be famous?
Yes.
Oh, you are working on it?
Yes.
That dreams happen. Dreams come true, baby. Don't ever give up. Are you good?
I'm good.
Take it all the way?
All the way.
What position?
I'm a goalkeeper.
A goalkeeper?
Yeah, I'm in the goals.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you got the big gloves on.
Definitely.
Yeah. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much, Steve.
All right, let's play. Basi?
Yes.
That is short for...
Basetana.
By what?
Basetana.
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 Ta, tsunami, ta.
What, did you just change your mind?
No.
Tell me, it's bas.
Basetana.
Basetana.
Yes.
Basi is short for Basetana.
That's it.
What do you do for a living, Basetana?
I'm a student.
Oh, a student at the university.
At the university.
Is it Peoria?
No.
No. Which one?
The University of the Witwatersrand.
Woo! Never heard of it, but woo! Sounds good. And what are your studies?
I'm studying education.
Oh, okay. Know what that is. Good.
Yes.
I don't have that either, so it's okay. So you ready?
Yes.
Name something people enjoy most about a matric dance.
I'd have to say taking pictures.
Taking pictures. So, what is the matric dance?
Prom.
Oh, the prom.
Yes.
Oh, okay. I got my man. What's up with you?
Andili. Yeah.
And you the photographer?
Yeah, I'm the photographer.
Okay, that's good, man. How long you been doing it?
About 4 years now.
Yeah.
Four years now.
My son is here. He's a photographer too. He's supposed to be out here taking pictures, but he's not.
So he's, I'm here.
He's like, I'm here. That's good. I have 2 sons that's pretty good in photography.
Oh,
yeah. So that's good, man. Let's go. Name something people enjoy most about the matric dance.
I'd have to say the after party.
Yes!
The after party!
Perfect one. Yeah.
Let's go.
Let's say ho.
Huh?
Let's say ho.
Let's say ho. Okay. Yeah. Let's say ho. What do you do?
I'm also a student.
Where? At the university.
Of Pretoria, where...
Of Pretoria. Yeah. Yeah. And what are your studies?
I'm doing chartered accounting. Yeah.
The money man.
Yeah.
Got you. All right, brother. Name something people enjoy most about a matric dance.
I'd say socializing with friends.
Socializing. Spilling the tea. Okay. Soccer man.
Yeah.
See ya.
Got it. Yeah.
You ready, man?
I'm ready. I'm gonna be looking for you, bro. I'm ready.
When I cut the TV on, you're gonna be playing with the Chiefs.
Yes. Huh? I'm a Pirates fan.
You're a Pirates fan?
Yeah.
I like all of them, so. Yeah, I ain't got to pick no side. Hell, I don't want no trouble. Go Pirates, yeah. Go Chiefs.
Nah.
See y'all. Name something people enjoy most about the matric dance.
Being able to take your date out or having a date.
Having a date. Only one strike, Ona. Give me something people enjoy most about a matric dance.
The food.
Basi, short for It's just short.
Short like me, Steve. Short like me.
Yeah, but a lot of good things come in small packages.
Dynamite does.
Dynamite does. You better watch yourself, little girl.
I mean, hello.
Name something people enjoy most about a metric dance.
I'd say showing off their cars that they arrive in.
Oh, y'all doing it like that, huh?
Uh-huh.
Oh, y'all pulling up in the big,
big
knife, right? Yeah. Did you go to the dance?
Yes.
What did the boy picks you up?
I went with my brother, Steve.
You went with your brother?
I went with my brother.
That's okay, I mean, yeah. You know, nobody deserved you, so it's okay.
Yes. Sometimes.
Yes.
Yes.
Hey, sometimes if you're not good enough, you can't have me.
Yeah.
If you're not good enough.
True.
Absolutely.
You might as well wait. So what did your brother drive?
My grandmother's car, Steve.
Oh, your grandmother's car. Okay. All right. Showing off the cars.
You can do this, guys. You got it.
And Dilly.
Yes.
Come on, man. One strike, but you can clear the board. This is the hardest one to get. This is the last one. Name something people enjoy most about a metric dance.
I'd have to go with the drinking that comes with it.
Oh, y'all been drinking. Oh, yeah, you in the high school, you just down there drinking. That's not gonna be up there. Drinking! All right, we gotta be careful now. Le sejo.
The G, you drag the G.
Drag the G.
Yeah.
Le sejo.
Ho.
Yes. Le sejo.
Yeah.
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 See, a lot of y'all don't know that, but you're supposed to drag the G. Ho. That's how you do that.
Yeah.
I'll teach that to you one day. Just hang in there. I'm going to show. Le sejo. You know what I'm saying? Ho. It's real sexy, you know what I'm saying? What's your name? Say, hey, what's your name, buddy? And le sejo.
Hey! Yeah!
I said, and the key word, ho. What you want to do now? Le sejo, careful, two strikes, the Moray family can steal. Name something people enjoy most about a metric dance. This is hard to get.
I'd say stunting on your teachers.
Say that again for me.
Stunting on your teachers.
Oh, stunting.
Yeah.
Stunting on your teachers, flexing on them.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Stunting on your teachers. All right, Moray, name something people enjoy most about a metric dance.
The venue.
The venue. All right, let's look at the remaining answer, number 7.
Thank you.
Well, we got a game, folks. The Moray family, not on the board. The KHUZWAYO family. KHUZWAYO family got 90. We got a game, folks. Don't go away. We'll be right back to play a family feud. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. The Moray family not on the board. KHUZWAYO family got 90. Give me Leafa, give me Bossy. All right. Leafa, you married, man?
No, sir.
No, sir.
I see. I know what you mean.
You
I got
saying?
You.
You got
that's
me?
That's why I'm dressed like this. I ain't dressed Leafa, like this for no
man.
Reason.
Leafa said, that's why I'm dressed like this. She could be here.
Exactly.
Yeah. The brothers over there, they watching, though. No. No? Damn. Anybody?
No.
She can't have nobody?
No.
We about to find out. We surveyed 100 people. We got top 7 answers on the board. Here we go. Tell me what announcement could someone make that might shock their parents? Leafa.
I just got an ear piercing. Or nose piercing.
I just got a piercing.
They either pregnant or got someone pregnant.
Oh, God. Well, look where we are. Oh, so soon. All right, let's go. And Dilly. Tell me an announcement somebody could make that would shock their parents.
I'd probably go with catching a case.
What do you mean by that?
A lawsuit, maybe having to go to court for a crime or something.
Got to go to court for a crime. Let's see who. Tell me an announcement somebody could make would shock their parents.
That they've been in a car accident.
They've been in a car accident. We got 2 strikes. We got to be careful on this one, because the Morey family can steal. Oh, soccer star, here we go. 2 strikes, Morey's can steal. Give me an announcement somebody can make will shock the parents.
That they gay.
That they're gay! Two strikes, the Morey family can steal. Honor, give me an announcement somebody could make that would shock their parents.
Come home drunk.
Come home drunk. Come on, family, we need this one right here. Tell me an announcement someone could make that would shock their parents.
A family member has passed away.
A family member has passed away. Let's look at the remaining answers. Number 7.
I'm getting a tattoo.
6.
I'm moving out.
5.
I failed.
4.
I'm dropping out.
3.
I'm getting divorced.
Well, that was round 2, everybody. Morey family not on the board. KHUZWAYO family got 150. Well, don't go away. The families are coming back, and we're going to double the points. We got a good one, y'all. We're playing Family Feud. Feud, everybody. The Morey family not on the board. KHUZWAYO family 150. Woo! Give me Bonita, give me Andile. Hello, Bonita.
Hi, Steve.
Lovely. Andile, welcome.
Thank you.
Let's go one hand. Here we go. Let's go. Top 6 answers on the board. Point values are double. Name something people do when they're really embarrassed. Andile.
They stutter.
They stutter. Bonita.
They bite their nails.
No. They bite their nails.
Nice. Okay. Nice.
Let's say go.
I would say that they end up just keeping quiet and looking down.
They just keep quiet. Pass or play?
We'll play.
All right.
Let's play, guys.
Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, soccer star! Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, future player for the Pirates!
Yeah!
Put your hands up!
Yeah.
I'm gonna be your hype man, baby.
Please.
I'm gonna look for you, man. But now let me explain something to you. You got to give it your all.
I will.
No, you every day. You got to give it all you got. To be great, you got to give it your all.
Yeah.
You don't give it your all, no way, okay? All right, let's go. Name something people do when they're really embarrassed.
They become shy.
They become shy. Name something people do when they're really embarrassed.
They sweat.
They sweat!
Yeah. Woo! Yeah, yeah,
yeah. All right, only one strike. Basic, give me something people do when they're really embarrassed.
They hide.
They hide! Yeah. Yeah. And delay, tell me something people do when they're really embarrassed.
They cover their mouth.
They cover their mouth.
In belief, in disbelief.
They cover their mouth. Lesejo, we got two strikes. You got to be careful, the Morey family can steal. Name something people do when they're really embarrassed.
I would say scratch their head.
They scratch their head. See ya, two strikes, the other family can steal. Some people do when they're really embarrassed.
I'd say, whew, this one's tough. Oof.
Come on, bro. Come on, cry.
Be nice if we got this one, family. Yeah. Be nice, cause it'll help you out, cause I see your energy.
Yeah.
You need this one. Name something people do when they're really embarrassed.
Cry, Steve.
They cry! Number four. Three. KHUZWAYO family got 278. Don't go away, because after the break, we're going to double the points. You're still in it. Don't worry about it. You're playing well, folks. Hey, we'll be back. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Morey family not on the board. KHUZWAYO family got 278. Give me Otis, give me Sleswesco. All right, here we go. Young Bloods. How old are you, Otis?
24.
Yes,
okay, sir.
That's good, man. Young Brothers. Top six answers on the board. Point values are double. Name something people argue about in a taxi. Let's get
home.
Home. Home.
We should go home.
Home.
Money.
Money.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Gentlemen, the Morey family. Yeah. See how it works? See, right when it looked like you wasn't gonna talk to Uncle Steve, here I am. Craig, introduce everybody.
All right, Steve. Next to me is my cousin Lefa. Next to him is his sister, also my cousin Bonita. Next to him is Otis, my cousin. And then I've got my little brother EJ.
Yeah. All right. Otis, what do you do, man?
I'm studying software development.
Oh, excuse me. It's very smart. I told you, they ain't got nothing to do with all these degrees. These some smart, I can tell they smart. EJ, what's happening, man?
I'm good, and you, Uncle Steve?
Always good. What you do, man?
I'm an up-and-coming artist and musician.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Musician?
Yeah.
You play an instrument?
Yeah, I could play a little bit of piano. A
little bit of piano?
Yeah.
So you an R&B singer?
Both, hip-hop and R&B.
Oh, both?
Yes, sir.
Oh, you Drake?
Oh, yeah, you already knew that. You already knew that, Steve.
I just found that out. I didn't really know that till. I said, can you do both? Somebody told me Drake, that's how I knew that. I have such a wonderful mind. So that's good, man. So what's your favorite type of music?
Hip-hop, would say, because
yeah.
I grew up with it for
a while.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, I actually got it from my brother, now that I think about it. See that man right there? Yeah.
He influenced me from a young age. He influenced you?
Yeah.
Oh, he a hip-hop artist, too?
Yeah. Nah. He listens to hip-hop.
Oh, he listened to it?
Yeah.
Oh, and that's what got you
going. That's what got,
Who's... Name your favorite artist.
I'm gonna name some SA artists, you know. Shout out to my boy Zuchi Coke Dope. Shout out to my boy Diamond. Shout out to my boy A. Reese. You know, those are my top three, like, artists in the game.
Yeah. I like that. I like that. You gonna give your boy some love. Some SA artists. Yeah, I like that. That's slick. All right, let's go, EJ. Name something people argue about in the taxi.
Where to sit, Steve.
Where to sit.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Now, I know that's a good answer, because I didn't know what them vans was that was going by. I just found out them was taxis, the dude hanging out the window. I didn't know what the hell was going on, but I just found out. Craig, what do you do, man?
I'm actually in IT. I work in a specialist bank.
Okay. IT, see that? Software, all that. Craig, name something people argue about in the taxi.
Windows open.
Windows open. Voulez-vous aller à ma window? Voulez-vous aller à ma window? You heard me? In the window. Voulez-vous aller à la window? Voulez-vous aller à la window? Boy, I done finally learned me something. I can't wait to say that. I might go out here tomorrow and just catch a cab for no damn reason. Who is that? Is that Steve Harvey? Yeah, scoot over, man, as soon as I sit down. Voulez-vous aller à la window? All right, man. Leifa, name something people argue about in a taxi.
The loud music, Steve.
The loud music. All right, we got two strikes now. We got to be careful. KHUZWAYO family can steal. Benita, what do you do?
I am an interior designer.
Oh, really? Hey. So let me ask you a question, Benita. So if my wife wants a house here and she buys the house and I need an interior decorator, are you just starting?
Nope, I've been doing it for 6 years.
6 years. You keep that in mind. You got two strikes now. We got to be careful. KHUZWAYO family can steal. Name something people argue about in the taxi.
The driver not stopping where you said. Yeah. Oh. Right. That's a good answer. If he didn't hear you because the music is too loud.
Okay, I understand. Oh, so the driver not stopping where you say.
Yeah, like passing your
stop.
That's
what you said.
Yeah.
See, y'all talk real fast over here, and I don't hear, because all I heard was, the driver standing where you say. And I went, well. And then I had to slow it down. He don't stop where you say. Otis, we got two strikes. We got to be careful. The other family can steal. Give me something people argue about in the taxi.
The reckless driving.
The reckless driving. That was a good answer. Don't worry. Name something people argue about in the taxi.
Being late.
Being late. We back in business, baby.
Yes.
Here's the missing answers, number six.
Wearing masks.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Put your mask on.
Yeah.
Overweight, I'm gonna win on your mask. Number four.
Fancy cashier.
Three.
Five.
Well, it's the last round, everybody. And there is everything to play for. Whoever has the most points at the end of this round goes on to play Fast Money. You will have a chance at winning the jackpot of 75,000 rand. We got a game now, everybody. The Moray family got 128. KHUZWAYO family got 278. Let's get it on. Give me EJ. Give me Sia. We have the two young future stars here. Both of them in the entertainment. One in sports, one in music. Let's get it on. I hope both of y'all make it. Give it your everything. Here we go. In this round, the points are tripled. We surveyed 100 people. Top five answers on the board. Name an occasion when you know people will say nice things about you. See ya.
Your funeral.
Your funeral. On up. Tell me an occasion where you know people say nice things about you.
Your wedding.
Yeah. Your yes. wedding. Woo! Bassi, tell me an occasion where you know people say nice things about you.
Your birthday. Yeah.
It's your birthday. It's your birthday. It's your birthday. And Dile, give me an occasion where you know people say nice things about you.
Hmm. Farewell.
At the what?
At your farewell, when they bid you goodbye.
At your farewell.
Like a farewell party, Steve.
A farewell party.
Yes.
Like when you're leaving the job.
Oh, when you like leaving the job.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you meant at your funeral. I was going over here. You at the funeral. At your farewell party. Listen to me. You have no strikes. This is very simple. If this answer's there, your family gets the points, your family wins the game. If it's not there, you're still alive, you have no strikes. Name an occasion when you know people say nice things about you.
I'd have to say your graduation.
This is for the win. Graduation! See ya, one strike. This is for the win. If it's there, your family wins the game. If it's not there, you're still alive. Name an occasion when you know people say nice things about you.
At a party.
At a party. We have two strikes. Anya, if it's there, your family gets the points, your family wins the game. But this time you have two strikes. If it's not there, the Moray family can steal And according to the points, they may win the game. Name an occasion when you know people say nice things about you.
On a TV show.
This is for the win. On a TV show for the win. Family, you have come from nowhere. Round after round after round, no points. You are now down to one answer and one answer only. If it's there, we will triple the points. Your family will win the game. If it's not there, the other family wins the game. One answer. This decides who plays for the 75,000 Rand jackpot. Drum roll, please. Name an occasion when you know people will say nice things about you.
Your anniversary, Steve.
This is for the win. Your anniversary! Let's look at the number four. Well, folks, y'all played really well. Y'all made a comeback. You're not going home empty-handed. You take away 6,400 Rand and a year's worth of KFC to the value of 10,000 Rand. Well done, everybody. And thanks again to our friends over at KFC. Great job. Great job, man. Hey, KHUZWAYO family, I need two of you right there to come and play Fast Money. I got Bassie and I got Sia. We'll be right back. We're going for Fast Money and the jackpot, 75,000 Rand. To the Feud, everybody. The KHUZWAYO family won the game. And now it's time to play
Fast Money.
All right, now, Bassie, here's how Fast Money works, okay? Sia's off stage. I'm gonna ask you five questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. If I can get back to it, if we have enough time, right? And then if you and Sia together come up with 200 points, look right there, tell everybody what you're gonna win.
Guys, are you sure your ears are open? We're winning 75,000 rands, guys.
She was just making sure y'all know the number. Are you ready?
Yes.
Now I'm talking to her. Hell yeah, we ready. We wanted to play next. All right, you ready?
Yes, Steve.
Okay. I love this crowd right here. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name something you associate with an astronaut.
Helmet.
Something that gives off heat.
Heater.
A country known for good wine.
South Africa.
Another term for being naked.
Bear.
A popular samosa filling.
Mince.
All right, come on, Bassie. Let's see how well you did. Here we go. Name something you associate with an astronaut. You said a helmet. Survey said? Something that gives off heat. You said a heater. Survey said? A country known for good wine, you said. South Africa, I've had some good wine, man. I ain't gonna lie to you. Survey said? Oh. Another term for being naked, you said, bare. Survey said? A popular smoosa.
Samosa.
Thank you for your help. Thank you. I'm glad you're here. A popular samosa filling, you said. Mint, survey said. Whoa. All right, Sia, soccer star, got some good news for you. Bassey got 125 points.
Got you too.
Now listen, man, you need 75 points to win for the jackpot of 75,000 rand. Now, to get 75 points in the second position is tough. You gotta focus, man.
Yeah.
Take your time and answer these questions. We got time. Give me good answers. I'm gonna ask you the same five questions. If you duplicate any of the answers, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again. You'll give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Yes, sir.
Let's remind everybody of Bassey's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. The clock will start after I read the first question. Name something you associate with an astronaut.
A spacesuit.
Something that gives off heat.
A heater.
Try again.
A stove.
A country known for good wine.
France.
Another term for being naked.
Nude.
A popular samosa filling.
Mince.
Try again.
Cheese.
All right, we need 75 points for 75,000 rand. Name something you associate with an astronaut. You said the space suit. Survey said? Outer space was the number one answer. We still need 75. Name something that gives off heat. You said stove. Survey said? Heater was the number one answer. We now need 60 points for $75,000. A country known for good wine, you said France, survey said. South Africa was the number one answer. We now need 35 points for 75,000 rand. Give me another term for being naked. You said nude. Survey said? Yeah. Oh. 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 Nude was the number one answer, and mints was the number one answer. Well, congratulations to the KHUZWAYO family. That's 75,000 rand. And listen to this. You put that with your points, you're walking out of here with a grand total, 101,500 rand. Wow. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time. Wow.